Temporal tables in Azure SQL DB simplify how you write applications based on eventing data or data that changes over time. Davide Mori is here to show us how it works today on Azure Friday. Hello again, and today on Azure Friday, I have Davide Mori, Program Manager from Azure SQL DB, on a continuing series where we're talking about all the great things that we can do with Azure SQL DB. Welcome, Davide. How are you?
Hey, Lara. Good. Thanks. Nice to be here again.
Yeah. So today we want to have a look at temporal tables. Can you talk to us about why these are important?
Yeah, you know, that's a very interesting question because we are so used to use data in its present state, but sometimes we actually need to know why data reached that state, right? So we need to keep track of all the changes that brought data from state A to B, which is the present state. And doing that is quite complex. Now, lately, several design patterns came up to solve this problem. CQRS and event sourcing are the most common and well-known, but they are quite complex. And first of all, you may not be able to implement them because you have an existing application. Or secondly, you don't want to tackle all that complexity. Maybe you just need to keep, you know, track of changes. That's why we have created temporal table in Azure SQL. And I just like to show it to you if you like.
Oh, that'd be great. I'd love to see this.
Yeah, so first of all, let me start to say that we are creating a regular table, but with three specific additional options here. The validity. So we want to say that we have a valid from and valid to that says when a row was valid over time, because otherwise without this information, the row will always represent like the present state, right? And then we inform the system that we want to use these two columns to actually be used in this temporal ability that we have. So let me create this table. Actually, I already did. And I already enabled system versioning. And then there is something interesting here, history table. So this means that every time I change something in this table, the row that has changed will be moved automatically for me. No trigger to write, no stored procedure, no code at all into this history table. Now, if that would be the only reason to use temporal table, you could say, well, that's not a big deal, right? Well, the problem starts when we want to query the data and run what we call as-of query, like run a query as if it was executed like 3 days ago. What data would I have seen at that moment in time? That's where the complexity arises. So let me show you, first of all, let's start to simulate that we have this table and we want to insert a couple of orders. Like I'm doing an order and you are doing an order. Perfect. Now some time passes and my order is completed. Perfect. Of course, other time passes, and let's say that someone puts in another order. And then, of course, time passes again, and then for some reason, you decide to cancel your order. And you go in the system, say cancel, and actually the system deletes your order. Now, if we go in the current table, we will see that there are only two orders, mine with the latest updated version and the other order made by Rob that is in. Your is completely disappeared, but if I need to do some analysis, I may need that information, like why your order isn't there. Maybe you call angry, I haven't received my order. I said, let's see what happened. And then I can go in the history and see exactly all the changes. So at some point, someone, for example, in this case, updated my order, and this is the moment in which that data was valid from that point in time to that point in time. And then we see that here there is still your order, but as a valid to some date that is not the future, which means that this is the day or the moment in which that row has been deleted. So here I can have that information, but I can even ask to Azure SQL to put back all that information into a single table for me. So I can say select from my order info, so the table I have created, for system time all means show me everything here. So all the changes. So as you can see, I can even have a kind of a duplicate primary key here, which is not duplicate because now we are taking into account the dimension of time into our query. So they are not duplicated because they happen in different point of time. That's very interesting, right? And so I can see my first order with the validity up to here, and it was in progress. Then the current value, which is defined by the fact that is in the near in the far future, is now completed. And then I can see that your order was placed and it was deleted on that date. So I can really rebuild everything. Now, to make to show you a little bit how this simplifies the ability to query those data, let me clean up everything and add some more data into this fictitious table so we can have, you know, more realistic data. Let me re-enable everything, and now let's take a look at the data again. So here I just added more and more rows, right? So I have a first order that went through several states. It was received, and then it was accepted, and then processed, and then blocked, and then was corrected. Kind of a typical situation in a logistic kind of field, right? Now, if I come to you and I ask you to give me the current data, you will just say, okay, the order right now has been closed, or it is closed, and that's all I got in my table. This is the current state. But I really want to understand what happened on the 8th of June 2021 for this specific order. So instead of having to go into the historical table, since this is everything is baked into the engine, so the engine knows about this need to keep track of changes, I can just say, select from my table for system time as of. And so I'm asking the engine to use the data that were valid, that was valid at that point in time. So here you go. So at the 8th of June, my order was in delivery. Perfect. And still, as you can see, I'm querying my kind of the only table I have, not the historical one.
Right. I was going to say you still have that history table, but you're never querying the history table.
The engine just
understands that data.
Yes.
Okay.
So I can choose. Let's say, for example, if I have to do a BI solution and I have to create a slow changing dimension, I'll probably want to query that table, right? Because it already contains all the changes for me. But if I'm creating an LTP solution where you're at the front desk and you just want to query the data and see exactly why we told you that the order was blocked for any reason at that point in time, you just specify as of and that's it. So your application is super simple, doesn't have to deal with two tables. And we can even do more complex stuff, like not only querying a single day, but over a time. So what was the state of the data over that period of time? And so I can see
on a range.
Right.
Yeah.
So I can see the history. And yeah. I mean, if you had to do this in the past or if you do it manually, you know how complex this could be, especially the query part, especially this. And by having this baked in the engine means for me as developer, one thing, simplify my life, make me able to focus on something that is unique to my application. This is something that is provided by Azure SQL, so I don't have to, take care of it. It's already done. I just have to enjoy it. And again, I'm more productive. I can take advantage of all the other features that Azure SQL has. Perfect.
Yeah, I could see so many places where I'm going to use this with some of my customer applications. Where can I go to learn more about how to take advantage of temporal tables?
Yeah, so here in temporal tables, there is this website, or this documentation website for Azure SQL. You have all the details about why you should use temporal, how temporal works, everything behind it. It's way more complex than I just show it, but here you can literally know everything about how the engine behaves. If you want to purge historical data, you even can. Let's say you only want to keep the last 6 months of historical data. You can do all this kind of configuration here, and you have all the detail, even some additional information on how, for example, use the history table to run analytical query with a column store index over it. So, yep, go for it. It's full of information.
That's great. That's great. The docs are so powerful to help.
Yeah.
So we've been learning all about temporal tables today on Azure Friday.
Hey, thanks for watching this episode of Azure Friday. Now I need you to like it, comment on it, tell your friends, retweet it. Watch more Azure Friday.